In this video, we're going to learn to create a circular array, and that is found on the left-hand toolbar right here where it says circular array. And to get started, I'm just going to travel to a new design tab with an empty workspace. And I think for this one, I'm just going to use a simple star shape. And so again, I can just click and drag to create myself a five-pointed star. And now with my star, I'm going to select it. And then choose down here, circular array. And so what happens is the shape that I have selected is repeated around a circle. And we have the ability to control in the tool options several things. First of all, the start angle and the end angle, the step angle and the step count, as well as options like whether or not we want our new objects to be made as clones and whether we want them to travel clockwise or counterclockwise, and we can add contour steps. Now, probably the easiest way to adjust these things is visually, and what you'll find is that the main there's multiple stars, and the one that you want to select is the one that has the red line, which means the end line and the beginning line are set together. And watch what happens if I grab on this handle here. First of all, I could move that star further away or closer together from the center, and I can also change the start and end angles so that it basically changes where those stars line up in the orientation of the circle. Now, the end angle and the start angle are attached, but if I grab onto any other star and move this way, notice what's happened now. The red line and the green line have been separated. And so the green line will represent the start angle, and the end line will represent the end angle. And now I can place the, so what was my step count? It's set at 12. That's the number of stars along my copy. If I'd like that to be, let's say, I don't know, 8. Now we have 8 stars in our circular array. And again, they're only arraying around half of the circle because of the way that I have set my start line and my exit line as being kind of like basically 90 degrees around from each other. If I grab that end line and I bring it around, I can bring it to anywhere. And as soon as I bring it all the way to the green line, it marries the red and the green together around our circular array. So visually or mathematically, either way, to create your array, you say apply. And that will set it on your screen and basically completes the task. Now I'm going to hit undo, select my star again, and choose to make the circular array again. And this time I also want to point out that when you're looking at the handles, you can either rotate a star or mirror image it, and that is based upon every other star. So if I rotate this one, it will rotate this one and every second star around the circle. If I mirror image this one, it will mirror image every second star around the circle. And so that is how you can, I guess, within a layout. Now maybe I'm going to not make this one, so I'll push the selection, rectangular selection tool, to just kind of reset, start over. And again, we'll go to our circular array tool. And so another option that we can choose in our tool options is the contour steps. And contour steps says, let's just change this from 0 to 2 and hit apply, hit enter, not apply. Apply would finish the task. So just hitting enter and maybe zoom out a little bit. So you can see there's the first array, there's the second contour step, and there's the third contour step. And now again, if I grab on that red handle, the start one, I can adjust where they go around the circle. And the further I pull them apart, the bigger my array gets, and the closer I put them together, the smaller or tighter that array will be. And so contour steps equals the number of additional sort of times around the circle. Now notice if I bring my contour steps out further away, when we change to contour steps, we also got the option for equal steps. And if I uncheck equal steps, it will mean that each row can have more around it. So let's turn this up. Right. So see how the first row has 12, second row has more than that, third row has more than that, because we have equal steps turned on or off. So when you're done, you simply push apply. And one more thing I'm going to undo is just to point out, when we have under the edit drop down menu, add new objects as clones turned on, and we use our circular array to create an array and say apply, and then we come in and we edit the shape of one of our stars like this. So let me zoom in on that. And perhaps I'll change the ray size. Then all of the stars in my group also have their new array size changed because they were added as clones of each other. And so this is how you can use the circular array tool.